Good morning students. Today we are going to discuss about module number 1. Here we are going to discuss the concepts like calculation of sag and tension and problems on sag. So first of all, here we are going to discuss about calculation of sag and tension. So the calculation of sag and tension are carried out for two cases. One is the support supporting the conductor are located at equal level, and the next one is the supports, that means towers, the supports, that means towers supporting the conductor are located at unequal levels. So first of all, here we are going to discuss the concepts like supports which are supporting at equal level. Let us consider a conductor which is supported by the two towers or two poles or two supports like A and B, which are located at the same level as shown in figure. Look at the figure. So these are the two towers, one is tower A, another one tower B. The two towers having same height, same distance. Okay, now the point O is the lowest point of the trajectory. Point O is the lowest point of this trajectory, and mathematically the point O is the midspan and can be proved. So we can know that from terminal A to terminal B, if we stretch any one wire, the midpoint is point O, and hence it is also called as origin. So the length, therefore capital L is equal to length of the span in meters. So here between terminal A to terminal B or tower A to tower B, the total length is L. If it is divided into two equal parts, from A to 0 it is L by 2, from 0 to B it is again L by 2. Therefore L is equal to total span of the conductor. L is equal length of the span in meters, and W is equal weight per unit length of the conductor in kg per meter, and T is equal tension in the conductor in kg. Now let us consider point P on the conductor, and let point O is the origin. So look at here, let us consider point P on this entire conductor, and O is the origin for the entire of this conductor, which is stretched between the towers A and B. So hence the coordinates of point P are x, y. So in x axis that is x, in y axis it is y, is the coordinates for the point P on this conductor. Next, the length of span L is small when compared to sag S, and hence the shape of the conductor can be take form in the form of a parabola. As usually we know that if the sag span length is small compared to length of the span, then it looks like a parabola shape. Let L is equal total length of the span between the terminal, between the two supports like A and B, and L by 2 is nothing but half of the length from terminal A to origin and origin to terminal B. Assume the length OP of the conductor is same as X, as the sag is small. Look at here the figure. Assume that length OP is nothing but X. Therefore mathematically we can write length of OP is equal capital X. Now there are two external forces which are acting on the conductor. One force is acting in horizontal direction, another force is acting on vertical direction. Therefore the tension T, that is the weight Wx, which acts at a distance x by 2 from point O or P. Look at here the weight is Wx, which takes place at the center of that the wire OP. And x by 2 is the length from O to the center, or x by 2 is the length from P to the center, or the overall length from O to P is X. Therefore the tension T acts in horizontal direction at point O. The tension, this is capital T, which acts in the horizontal direction at point O. Next, taking moments of these two forces about point P and equating them, we get, then we are going to take the two tensions, one is tension T, another one is tension Y. One is in horizontal direction, one is in vertical direction. So tension T is in horizontal direction, tension Y is in vertical direction for this center of that length of a conductor between O to P. Therefore we can multiply the equation, the two tensions T into Y, that is equal its weight Wx. Wx is the weight in vertical position, and x by 2 is the length from either O to this center or P to this center. Therefore Wx into x by 2 at right hand side. Therefore T into Y is equal to Wx square by 2. if you send t to right hand side, then y is equal to w x square by 2t or w by 2t into x square. This equation shows the trajectory is a parabola because the curve is like looks like a parabola curve. At the supports A and B, the vertical distance y from the origin O, it indicates that sag S. If you look at this figure, the vertical distance from origin or from the center to point P, that is y. Therefore, we can write, we can replace that y as S, then at the same time, that is x. X is nothing but, in this figure, x is nothing but length of the conductor O to P. Therefore, if I am going to replace that x by L, then the above equation can become as S is equal, x is equal L for total length of the conductor, the total span of the conductor between the two supports, or L by 2 is the total, I mean L by 2 is the half of the length of the conductor from terminal A to O or O to B. Therefore, y is equal to s is replaced and x is replaced with L, then the formula can become as w by t 2t L square. As we know that for full length of the conductor, the formula is w by 2t into L square. For half of the length, L can become as L by 2, then w by 2t into L by 2 whole square, that is w by 2t into L square by 4. If you multiply the total overall sag, that is the maximum sag formula, s is equal to WL square by KT. Therefore, capital S equal total span length and capital T is equal total tension of the conductor. Then the resultant sag at any point P of the conductor is the difference between that slope of that conductor 0 to P, that is S minus Y, that become as WL square by AT minus WX square by 2T. Sag at any point that become as W by AT of L square minus 4X square, if you take that AT as common at here. So the sag at any point, the overall formula W by AT of L square minus 4X square, and the maximum sag formula, that is S is equal to WL square by AT. Next, problems on sag. Let us discuss the first problem. An overhead transmission line has a span of 220 meters. The conductor weighing a weight of 804 kg per kilometer. Calculate the maximum sag. If the ultimate tensile strength of the conductor is 5758 kg, assume a safety factor of 2. So given data, the span length L is equal to 220 meters they given, ultimate tensile strength of the conductor small t they given, that is 5758 kg, and safety factor they given as 2. Therefore, the maximum tension formula capital T is equal ultimate strength divided by factor of safety, that is equal 5758 divided by 2, that is equal 2879 kg. Now weight of the conductor W they given, that 804 kg per kilometer. So per kilometer means we can convert into meter as 804 into 10 to the power of minus 3 kg per meter. Now the maximum sag formula S is equal to WL square by AT. W already we know that 804 into 10 to the power of minus 3 into L. L is they given here 220 whole square divided by 8 into T. Capital T they given as 2879. So if you do the simplification, the maximum sag S is equal to 1.69 meters at here for the given problem. Next, one more problem. A transmission line has a span of 150 meters between level supports. The line conductors has a cross section area of 1.25 cm square and circuit weights 120 kg per 100 meters. If the breaking stress of the copper conductor is 4220 kg per centimeter square, calculate the maximum sag for a safety factor of 4. Assume a maximum wind pressure of 90 kg per meter square of a projected surface. Write the given data at here. The span length they given L is equal to 150 meters. Cross section area of the conductor A is equal to 1.25 cm square. If you convert that centimeter square into meter square, it becomes as 1.25 into 10 to the power of minus 4 meter square. And weight of the conductor is equal to 120 kg per 100 meters, that is equal to 1.2 kg per meter. Then breaking stress is equal to 4220 kg per centimeter square and safety factor is equal to 4. Now we are going to calculate the tension T. Formula, tension T is equal to breaking stress into cross section area of the conductor divided by factor of safety. If you do the simplification here, 4220, that is breaking stress into cross section area of the conductor 1.25 divided by 4, it becomes as 1319 kg. Now diameter of the conductor, that is equal D is equal, actually area of the sphere A is equal pi D square by 4. Here D is equal square root of 4A by pi. If D is equal square root of 4A by pi, then it becomes that simplification 1.26 meters. Then weight of the conductor pressure, that becomes 1.34, and resultant weight of the conductor can become